I'm Marina Latif from Yes to Tech, and welcome back to my channel. Wondering how to use Canva Pro? In this Canva Pro tutorial for beginners, I'll be sharing Canva tips and tricks that you can do with a Canva Pro account. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly whether Canva Pro is worth the money and Canva Pro features that you can use to save you time and effort when creating your designs. If you're excited about this video, make sure to like this video, hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a new video. And with that said, let's jump right in. First off, if you don't have a Canva Pro account yet, just click on the link in the description box below to try it for free. Canva Pro has a number of advantages when compared to Canva Free. Canva Pro makes it easy for you to sort through all of your existing designs by offering unlimited folders and 100 gigabytes of storage for all of your designs. You also gain access to priority support if you ever have an issue. When creating a design with Canva Pro, you'll gain access to over 60 million photos and elements. You can sort photos in Canva Pro by topic, view recently used and trending photos, as well as use the search bar to locate and filter through any photos of your choice. When it comes to elements in Canva Pro, you can sort them by recently used, featured, and type, as well as use the search bar to locate and filter through any elements of your choice. When adding text to a design in Canva Pro, you can use one of their 3,000 font options available or upload your own. If you don't know how to upload your own font to Canva, make sure to watch my video on how to import new fonts on Canva. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below. You may have noticed when I opened the font options dropdown that there is this brand font section. With Canva Pro, you can stay on brand with set and forget brand logos, brand colors, and brand fonts. This makes it way faster to customize your Canva Pro designs so that they fit in with your brand. If you've created a design with Canva Pro that you really enjoyed and you wish to repurpose that design for other platforms, Canva Pro makes it really easy to do so with a magic resize option. All you have to do is click on Resize up top, choose a custom size or one of Canva Pro's preset design template sizes, and then click on Copy and Resize. Then all that's left is to adjust certain elements so that they properly fit on your design, and you'll be good to go. Canva Pro also allows you to bring your creativity to life with animations and GIFs. To see Canva Pro's animations in action, make sure to watch my video on how to create animated Instagram stories using Canva. For a step-by-step tutorial on how to create a GIF, make sure to watch my video on how to create a GIF in Canva. I'll leave the link to both these videos in the description box below. Another cool feature of Canva is the ability to schedule your social media directly from within Canva. Depending on the design template you chose, Canva Pro will suggest where to publish your design directly to, such as publish to Pinterest, or you can always click on the three little dots to access other share options, including Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. For even more ideas of what you can do with Canva Pro, make sure to watch my video on 8 Canva tips and tricks you may not know about. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below. If you're serious about using Canva Pro to its fullest extent, make sure you check out our free cheat sheet with 9 brilliant tools that you should use below this video to learn more about how you can save time and boost your productivity in your online business. Make sure you comment below and let me know which Canva Pro feature you're most excited to try out. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below for new videos every Tuesday and Thursday at 9:45 a.m. Eastern, and stay tuned for my next video, which is about how to make a mood board in Canva. As you wait for my next video to go live, check out these 2 videos I have right here, and I'll see you in my next video.